everyone. I have always been asked, when people are, time for them to renew their membership dues, what is the chamber going to do for us? What are you doing for us? Before, in the past couple of years anyway, all we ever did was the annual dinner and the golf tournament. So I've listened to everybody's suggestions, and this is what we've come up with. And if this goes over, like I'm hoping it will, I will probably add some more events next year. Because that's not covering the medical field in this and some other areas. So, and I want to do events that covers everybody. So, the first thing that we're looking at will be Saturday, April 1st. It will be at the convention center, and it's going to be a home improvement. This is set up to cover contractors, home improvement businesses, realtors, banks. It will not cost you anything for the booth. You just come in and you set up. Hopefully I can get you in there the night before so we can be ready to go at 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm not sure yet how much space each person is going to have or each business until I know how many people are going to participate and then I can divide up square footage. Any questions?
And keep in mind that for some people, like for instance, the school can always set up a booth too for maybe people that are going to be moving into the area. You kind of have to think out of the box when it comes to it because, you know, I added the bank onto it because we can reach more people with some of our loan offerings and different stuff like that. So if you have something that could, you know, qualify, we're not going to, if you're at the school, we're not going to be able to come or something like that. So just want to add that.
So there's going to be a charge for the public to come in?
Yes.
How much?
So, for example,
I'm sorry.
Attendance? No,
that'll
be just a different.
Oh, okay.
I've never been
to one of these. Guys, still that one
in
Dickman, and they charge, it's not a large amount, I think it's like $5 or $7 a person to get in.
It's like realtors could set up a booth, banks that make home loans could set up a booth, people that do concrete, people that do cabinets, mm-hmm. all those type of things.
People want to build homes because I'm sure, you know, spring is your window for people that want to build homes and buy homes and do improvement.
Could they possibly bring maybe a canned donation or something for money off the mission?
Mm-hmm. What do you mean?
Like it's set,
like you donate canned goods for the whole foundation?
Sure.
Yeah. Then on Saturday, May 13th, we're going to call it Shopping with Moms because that's the Saturday before Mother's Day. And this is to help promote our local businesses, hairdressers, spas, even cell phones. You know, they might want to go buy mom a new cell phone for Mother's Day. Restaurants, the thing with restaurants is we're hoping that they'll offer some specials. If you come in, you have breakfast or lunch, you have pajamas, you get a certain job. We're even going to, you know, anybody who has something to offer that could benefit mom, meaning even auto repair, mom might need her oil change or her tires rotated and balanced or whatever. But the trick here is they have to be in pajamas and I don't want anybody showing up in something skimpy.
Some pajamas I have.
The thing here for all these events is the advertisements. I'm kind of skipping ahead here, but that's what's going to cost the members. And to participate in these events, it's $125, and we take care of the advertising. If you've got a logo or something or certain special that you're running, if you can email that to me when it gets close to time so that I can put the ad together and get it to Joey.
So the event would be sponsored by a particular company. That's what the $125 is for, to be the sponsor.
No, it's for the advertising. Has everybody kind of seen like what Princeton Chambers does with theirs? They have a big advertising of like the specials. So, for instance, if Bows and Cleats was going to do like 30% off and then free engrave, I don't know, just something, then that's what they would advertise. And we put them all together in the newspaper. It's, you know, the events advertised in the newspaper. And then everybody's ads are underneath it with your special that you're doing that day, and then anything like that. We take care of all that for you. We'll take care of putting the ad together. We'll take care of getting it all put together. All you have to do is let us know that you want to participate. Okay. $125 will cover all the events for the year. If there's only like one or two that you want to do, then we can kind of talk through that. But the advertising we take care of completely. You don't have to do anything for it. Any questions about the advertising? Okay, Friday, June 2nd is our annual dinner event. That was the only Friday we had left to get. We are meeting a speaker from NASA who's going to come here and discuss the eclipse. So if you got any questions about what all the hype is about, why everybody's coming here, thousands and tens of thousands of people are supposed to be here, he can explain everything to you and why it is such a phenomenon. We are not planning on doing auctions this year like we've done in the past. It's really a lot of trouble to get it together, to get everything donated, and then get it all set up. And I think we're better off to just have four or five items. We're going to just kind of do a raffle. You buy tickets. We had a few of those items last year. We tried that out. It worked pretty good. And then we'll probably have to split the pot at the door. Friday, August 18th to the 21st is the eclipse. Currently, the only chamber event we have scheduled is Art in the Park. And when I say we have scheduled, actually there's two people who are pretty much taking care of this. That's Belinda Talbert and Marsha Daniels. They know people who are in the art field, and they're pretty much making the contacts and getting it set up. But I told Belinda that we would help her out any way we could. We're not doing anything else in August because of the eclipse is so big. Friday, September 15th is our annual golf scramble, and it is already on the books at Mineral Mounds. So we really need to get 18 teams this year if we can. It makes it a whole lot more competitive, and it just is a better sport. October 14th, the Taste of Lake Barkley. This is going to be to promote restaurants, local meat and food seafood suppliers. Again, this is part of the advertising fee is part of the $10. It's going to be at the Lee S. Jones Convention Center, and we have reserved the center the night before so that you can come in the evening before, get your booth set up, and be ready to go the next morning. There will be a fee at the door for a plate. This is the way Paducah does it. They have the taste of the town. You buy a plate for a certain fee, and then you go around and you get to sample all the goods. This is basically just to help our businesses promote what they have to offer. Okay, so in December, we have always, every year we have the same conversation regarding Christmas, and about how we used to have Christmas lights in the park in the city. I don't know people remember those, if anybody's here, but I used to put them up with my mom because she was part of the chamber then. So there was a huge Christmas display, so we kind of wanted to get back to that. So the event will actually be like an all-day event. It'll be on December 2nd, and it'll be in the annual city park. We're trying to raise some money now to purchase the large Christmas displays. If you don't know how much they cost, I about fell on the floor the first time that I looked in the book to see. But there's no charge for the event. We'll be taking donations of either monetary means or a canned good, and it'll all be donated to the Hope Food Bank. And basically, the event's going to have stuff for kids. There's going to be food. Santa's going to be there. And then at 5 o'clock that night, we'll turn on the lights in the park, and they'll stay on until after Christmas. People can donate. They can come walk through the park. It's going to be like a walkthrough thing, and they can look at the lights and different stuff like that. So that's going to be. The event during the day is going to be different. We're going to be looking for people to help with like hot chocolate and face painting and different stuff like that for that day. So that's kind of still in the works because it's in December, but that's how that's going to be.
then in the evening, we're going to again get our shops, our local shops, to stay open late and participate, so people can do some Christmas shopping after the day in the park.
I got a question on that. Are you going to, I know you're still working on it, but are you going to put together a package that says for businesses, or do they have to come up with their own lights? Are you guys going to charge a fee and then go buy the lights?
No, we're taking care of all the lights.
Okay.
The only thing that the businesses would be charged of that day would be like a booth that they wanted to do. Like face painting, hot chocolate, cookies, or anything like that for the community. This is more of a community event, because I think we miss, like after summer we kind of just leave, so people leave and we don't really do anything. So it's going to kind of be for the community, but you're also be able to advertise and all that stuff. So
what's your goal as far as how much to buy? You thought about it?
No, we don't know about that. I know that I participated, I'm part of the call team, the call leadership team for Caldwell and Lyon County. And we did Small Town Christmas for Princeton this year. I was in charge of some stuff and I was surprised at how many people actually came out. So I'll be kind of considering that because you'll have people from Lyon County and Princeton that will come. So there was lots of people.
For people that want to set up like hot chocolates and different things that you said, would they pay to do that?
No.
They can just come and do it?
Yes. But they have to buy their own, whatever they're giving
away. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but no, there's no charge or anything like that.
But they need to let us know that they're planning on doing
it. So the people that want the hot chocolate, buy it or is it given to them?
That's up to the business. That would be up to whatever the business wanted to do. I would hope that it would just be a given. It would be just given away as a community event. But if they need to recoup some of the charges, they can charge $2 for a hot chocolate or.
Maybe just ask for a donation.
Going back to Wade's question, we're thinking $5,000 to $10,000 to get us started. And we've talked to some people that we think are going to maybe make some donations. And then as we go on each year, we can add to that.
Yeah, I mean, that's the best way to do that is piecemeal.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we contacted some bigger corporate sponsors for this year, and then obviously each year we would hope to add to it. I mean, we're not going to be able to do a whole Mike Miller Park right from the very beginning. So.
Unless we raid Lillard and Danny's
little property. Yeah. 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 She'd give me some Christmas lights.
She'd be like, I don't know where it all is. So, come to our community event. That's the way you're going to raise money, is you're going to like put their advertisement out there and say thanks to these sponsors.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I know that I would like, the court was trying to figure out what we could do last year. You know, we were all meeting and
yeah.
Never really did anything. So I'd like to coordinate with you guys and see if we can do something either at the courthouse or if we need to do ours down there. But I would want it to sort of.
Yeah, we could all be.
Match up. We've never done anything, and I always wanted to.
Yeah. And I think, like, this year, the city of Catawba did their Christmas lighting on that Sunday, and I think it's going to stay the same throughout the year. So, like, we would have our event on that Saturday, and then Catawba would have theirs on Sunday, so it would kind of be like a whole opening of Christmas season, that kind of thing.
And then Princeton does theirs the following weekend, so.
Yeah. So.
Well, I like it.
I have one more thing I want to talk about. It's not necessarily a chamber sponsored event. I am a member of the Caldwell and Lyon County Leadership team, and if anybody doesn't know what that is, it's a group of us that we had interviewed. I mean, like we applied to be in the program. It's a year-long event. Visit local businesses within Lyon County and Caldwell County, and we actually do two service projects each year. The first one was Small Town Christmas, which was in Princeton. The second one is going to be Joseph's Joy Prom, and if anybody is familiar with that, they did it last year in Princeton. This year it's going to be in Lyon County on April 15th. It is a prom that is put on that is completely free for disabled teenagers and adults. Everything is completely donated. We have a small budget for it, but we have to raise everything. So there'll be probably an article in the paper here pretty soon, kind of giving some details and stuff. There was a news story last week in the Princeton paper about it, but we basically are gonna need volunteers. I think last year they had 150 volunteers. We had 50 participants from this county and Caldwell County. Basically they come, they walk in on a red carpet, they get dinner, they get shoe shine, they get hair and makeup, they get a free dress, they get a free suit, and then we have a DJ and we have a prom for them, okay? So it is an amazing event. I didn't actually go to last year's in Princeton, but I have seen videos and different things, and it is absolutely amazing. So I personally will probably be contacting a lot of you guys. If anybody has dresses, like prom dresses or old dresses that they don't want, that are in their closet, if they know high school students that have them, that would like to donate them, we will take them and bring them to me at the Third Bank. Suits, anything like that, we'll take, so.
Did you say you had a date?
April 15th.
Are you over here?
Yes. We're actually going to be in that building. We do a hospitality room for the parents, where we do massages and pedicures, anything like that, because the parents usually don't get time away from that if they have a special needs kid. So.
Did you say you were wanting this building too?
We have it scheduled.
See it. I'll make sure though.
I wasn't in charge of that. That would be Brent Wyatt.
That's your problem. Because he probably tasted me, and that's probably.
I think that's how that went.
I'll get this building on there too.
So, is there any questions about that?
If you have someone in mind that you would think would enjoy that, who would get in contact?
You can call me or contact me. We'll have applications and that kind of stuff for people to fill out. We currently are having issues getting it open on a computer right now, so that's kind of been a problem. But I will have them at the bank where you can come and pick them up and then bring them back to me. Hopefully, as soon as I know, I'll probably. Get it out there. Hopefully, we have our next meeting next month. We'll have all the dates. Anybody who's wanting to volunteer, it will have to be, you'll have to go through training for dealing with a special needs person, because we will have caregivers and different people to walk around with some of these people, different stuff like that. Those dates haven't been set, but.
Maybe Cheryl could send out a copy of the application to all of our members.
Yeah, as soon as I can open, have one.
Yeah.
Is there an area that covers, is Trigg County included in it?
Right now it's just Caldwell and Lyon, because we haven't really expanded. It's going to be an open-year event regardless. If you have people in mind that might be, I'd be more than happy to give you an application. We don't want it to get too big too quick and us not be able to handle it, because there's
but there's no cost to the people coming or their caregivers.
Nope.
Maybe is there an age cutoff?
16 and older. If you have somebody who's younger, please talk to me first. I'm not going to turn anybody away. I mean, unless they're like 5, but there will be adults and older people there.
And these are all intellectually. We need type individuals, right?
Do you have any questions? Any questions about any of the other stuff we talked about? Okay, that's all we have.
I'm going to draw a name.
Oh, yeah.
All right, I feel like Katie's here.